In last session of the molecular basis of inheritance, we have studied DNA replication. DNA replication. In the DNA replication, one parental DNA produces two daughter DNA molecules. One parental DNA produces two daughter DNA molecules. In the each daughter DNA molecule, one is the parental strand, that is old strand. Another one is the newly synthesized strand, either lagging strand or leading strand. So in each daughter DNA molecule, one is the old strand, another one is the new strand. This method of DNA replication is called semi-conservative method of DNA replication. Here semi means half. Half of the DNA is the parental DNA and remaining half of the DNA is the newly synthesized DNA, either in lagging strand or in leading strand. And In the DNA replication, to undergo unzipping mechanism, important, I can repeat once again, and also glancing the important highlights of important points of DNA replication. For example, this is linearly oriented double stranded DNA. In this linearly oriented double stranded DNA, one strand is 5' to 3', another one is the 3' to 5'. In anti-parallel direction, in anti-parallel manner, and this is the point of horizon, origin of replication site, or insertion point, at the point of horizon, to undergo unzipping of DNA due to breaking of hydrogen bonds in between nitrogen bases, be concentrated here, at the point of horizon, at the point of horizon, unzipping of DNA occurs due to breaking of hydrogen bonds present between nitrogen bases. This is catalyzed by helicase enzyme break the hydrogen bonds in between nitrogen bases. This results in the two DNA strands get separated in the form of Y-shaped structure. Such unzipped Y-shaped DNA molecule is called replication fork. In the replication fork, there are two single-stranded DNAs. Here the separated strands are the single-stranded DNAs. Such a separated single-stranded DNA in the replication fork are called DNA templates. DNA templates, their function is synthesis of a new DNA strand and also formation of a RNA primer. Be remember this point for neat exam. DNA templates not only synthesize the new DNA strands, either leading strand or lagging strand. It synthesize both DNA strand and RNA primer, because RNA primer is the essential raw material for replication of DNA. That means the RNA primer is the special type of RNA. RNA primer is the special segment of RNA synthesized by DNA template in primes of RNA polymerase. Here the important function of RNA primer is it should maintain The replication of DNA always 5' to 3' direction. You should remember, on the whole DNA template stands, on one of the whole DNA template stand, the synthesis of new strand takes place from one end of the RNA primer. On one of the whole template stand, the formation of new strand takes place towards inner side due to continuously addition of DNA nucleotides. You should remember, on one of the old DNA template strand, the addition of DNA nucleotides occurs in continuously from one end of the RNA primer. This so continuously synthesized strand is called leading strand. Leading strand or continuous strand. It takes place from 5' to 3' direction, because old template strand direction is 3' to 5'. On the 3' to 4' old template strand, the formation of a new strand occurs towards inner side of the replication fork from 5' to 3'. This direction is maintained by RNA primer. And at the same time, in another old strand, the addition of DNA nucleotides occurs in discontinuously. Addition of DNA nucleotides occurs in discontinuously. It prints of many RNA primers. Number of RNA primers, the addition of DNA nucleotides takes place in discontinuously towards away from the replication fork or towards outside from the replication fork from 5' to 3' direction. So yeah, the whole template strand is 3' to 5', and discontinuous strand direction is 5' to 3'. This discontinuous strand is called leading strand. Lagging strand due to presence of many RNA primers. And each single stranded DNA segment of the lagging strand, very important for one more question, each single stranded DNA of the lagging strand is called Okazaki fragment. See, Okazaki fragment are each single stranded DNA fragment of the lagging strand is called Okazaki fragment after discovery of scientist or Okazaki. So, in the addition of DNA nucleotides on one of the old template strand is continuous, that is called leading strand. And on another old strand, the addition of DNA nucleotides is discontinuously due to presence of RNA primers. This discontinuous strand is called lagging strand. Your orientation, direction of lagging strand is also 5' to 3'. Very important. Such 5' to 3' direction, replication of DNA maintained by RNA primer. Synthesis from DNA template strand in presence of RNA primase or RNA polymerase enzyme after formation of a leading strand. The RNA primers of lagging strand replaced by DNA polymerase first. And gaps were filled by DNA nucleotides from the nucleoplasm. Because nucleoplasm containing DNA nucleotides in triphosphate condition, In triphosphate condition, during DNA replication, each DNA nucleotide of the triphosphate condition can eliminates, can separates two phosphate functional groups and yield energy. This liberated energy consumed by DNA replication. It is clearly known that the replication of DNA does not depending on mitochondria for their energy requirement. That's why the DNA nucleotides performs dual functions. One is the supplement of energy, another one is the substrate for the DNA nucleotide chain. DNA nucleotide chain. So, such DNA nucleotides, after elimination of two phosphate functional groups, used by DNA polymerase third, DNA polymerase third, and to establish phosphodiester bond in between sugar moiety and phosphate group, leads to synthesis of new strand. Such continuous strand is called leading strand, and discontinuous strand is called lagging strand. It is maintained by DNA polymerase third enzyme. Addition of DNA nucleotides and synthesis of new strands, formation of new strands takes place by the help of DNA polymerase third enzyme. DNA polymerase third enzyme. So, the major function of DNA polymerase third is, the important function of DNA polymerase third is formation of phosphodiester bond and to synthesize a polynucleotide chain, a polynucleotide DNA chain. That is the role of DNA polymerase third enzyme. So, the formation of new strands catalyzed by DNA polymerase third. And in the discontinuous strand, in the lagging strand, RNA primers are replaced. Gaps were filled by DNA nucleotides in presence of DNA polymerase first. DNA polymerase first. Later on, the Okazaki fragments joined by, stitched by, joined by DNA ligase enzyme to produce a newly synthesized strand, a newly formed strand. So, after DNA replication, the formation of one strand is caucus, it takes place towards upper direction from 5' to 3'. The synthesis of a new strand on one of the old DNA template strand occurs from bottom to top in upper direction in the form of 5' to 3' direction. And in another old template strand, another old template strand, the formation of a new chain, formation of new strand takes place from top to bottom in downward direction in the form of 5' to 3' direction. So, after complete DNA replication, these two strands coil towards right hand direction in clockwise direction to produce one DNA molecule. In another old template strand, they are coiled towards to the right hand direction in presence of polymerase enzyme. Never unwinding, so in presence of polymerase enzyme to produce second DNA molecule. In the each DNA molecule, in the each daughter DNA molecule, one is the parental strand. That means in the daughter DNA molecule, one strand is directly received by daughter DNA molecule. One parental DNA strand directly received by daughter DNA molecule. And another one is the newly formed strand, newly synthesized strand, either in the form of leading strand or in the form of lagging strand, discontinuous strand. So, in the each daughter DNA molecule, 50% of DNA is the old strand and 50% of DNA is the new strand. That's why the method of DNA replication is always
सेमी कंजर्वेटिव, सेमी पेरेंटल स्टैंड, कंजर्व स्टैंड, कंजर्वेटिव स्टैंड. सो दिस मेथड ऑफ डीएनए रिप्लिकेशन इज कॉल्ड सेमी कंजर्वेटिव मेथड ऑफ डीएनए रिप्लिकेशन. इट वॉज एक्सपेरिमेंटली प्रूव्ड बाय मिसेलसन एंड स्टाल साइंटिस्ट. Next one, give the procedure of Michelson and Stahl experiment. How DNA is always a semi-conservative method of replication. But before I am going to the explanation of Michelson and Stahl experiment, once again, glancing the extra information of DNA replication involved enzymes. In DNA replication, there are different several types of enzymes are involved. Very important for extra information, for specific neat information. Yeah, there are three different types of DNA polymerases in prokaryotes. You should remember, in prokaryotes, there are three different types of DNA polymerase enzymes gets involved. That is, DNA polymerase first. DNA polymerase first. Very important. This enzyme was first discovered by Kornberg. DNA polymerase first was first discovered by Kornberg. Hence, it is also called Kornberg enzyme. Very important. DNA polymerase first was first discovered by scientist, molecular biologist Kornberg. So it is also called Kornberg enzyme. And also, he was the first person to synthesize the DNA in laboratory condition. You should remember this point. In laboratory condition, under aseptic condition, in very first time, synthesis of DNA conducted by Kornberg. So, DNA polymerase first enzyme was first noticed by, discovered by Kornberg. So, it is also called Kornberg enzyme. Now, this enzyme is responsible for the function of DNA polymerase first is removal of RNA primers and gaps were filled by DNA nucleotides. Where is it? The replacement of RNA primers in the discontinuous strand, in the lagging strand, in the discontinuous strand takes place by the help of DNA polymerase first and gaps are filled by DNA nucleotides. So here one important neat question is DNA polymerase first responsible for, question no? DNA polymerase first responsible for, first option no? replace the RNA primers. Second one is the replacement of DNA segments. Third one is the fulfill of gaps. And last one is the A+C. Yeah, the right option is the A+C. Means here DNA polymerase first responsible for removal of RNA primers in the lagging strand. Thereafter, the creating gaps fulfilled by DNA nucleotides is the function of DNA polymerase first enzyme. So that the DNA polymerase first, based on their function, is also called DNA repair enzyme. You should remember this statement in clearly. DNA repair enzyme is the DNA polymerase first or Kornberg enzyme. And next, the second one is the DNA polymerase second. DNA polymerase second. See, it is the rare reactive enzyme in DNA replication. You should remember the rare reactive
involved enzyme in the DNA replication is DNA polymerase second. See, it is also called DNA repair enzyme. Means this enzyme is also repair the DNA replication, DNA segment. Listen here, whenever absence of DNA polymerase first, if the DNA polymerase first or DNA polymerase first is absent during DNA replication, that function is performed by DNA polymerase second enzyme. That's why DNA polymerase second is also called DNA repair enzyme in absence of DNA polymerase first. And next one is the DNA polymerase third. DNA polymerase third, very important. This enzyme was discovered by Delusia and Keims, Ceims. DNA polymerase third is discovered by Delusia and Keims, and this enzyme is the more reactive enzyme in the DNA replication. You should remember this statement. This enzyme is more participating DNA replication because it is responsible for formation of leading and lagging strands by the addition of DNA nucleotides. You should remember this statement clearly. The formation of leading and lagging strand by the addition of DNA nucleotides takes place by the help of DNA polymerase third enzyme. Means the synthesis of new strands, formation of new strands takes place by the help of DNA polymerase third enzyme, discovered by Delusia and Keims. Hence, it is also called replicate enzyme, DNA replicate enzyme, another name of DNA polymerase third. These are all the three different types of DNA polymerases, first, second, and third in prokaryotic cells, in bacterial cells, in prokaryotic cells. Whereas in eukaryotic cells, DNA polymerase is of five different types in eukaryotic cells, like DNA polymerase alpha. DNA polymerase alpha, it is responsible for synthesis of leading strand. Very important, you should remember all these details, all these informations for NEET exams and CET exams. DNA polymerase alpha responsible for synthesis of leading strand. DNA polymerase beta. DNA polymerase beta is also called repair enzyme. DNA repair enzyme, also called DNA polymerase first. Means this is responsible for replacement of RNA primer and capture failure by DNA nucleotides in the lagging strand, in the discontinuous strand. So, in eukaryotes, DNA polymerase beta, also called DNA polymerase first, this is responsible for repairing of DNA. And next one is the DNA polymerase delta. DNA polymerase delta helps in synthesis of lagging strand, formation of lagging strand. You should remember, formation of leading strand takes place by the help of DNA polymerase alpha. Synthesis or formation of lagging strand takes place by the help of DNA polymerase delta. Most important confusing concepts. And DNA polymerase gamma. DNA polymerase gamma. Important. This enzyme present in mitochondria and chloroplast of eukaryotic cells. Mitochondria and chloroplast of eukaryotic cells. Because in eukaryotic plant cell, the cytoplasm having cytoplasm contained mitochondrial cell organelle as in the form of powerhouse of the cell. And chloroplast present in the form of kitchen room of the cell. So inside the stroma of the chloroplast, within the mitochondrial matrix of the mitochondria, is the circular DNA molecules. Such circular DNA molecules are responsible for DNA replication by using DNA polymerase gamma enzyme. So the DNA polymerase gamma present in the cell organelles like mitochondria and chloroplast, responsible for DNA replication. And last one is the DNA polymerase E. DNA polymerase E means so DNA polymerase epsilon. See, this is also called damage repair enzyme. This enzyme is also called damage repair enzyme because in case absence of DNA polymerase beta, DNA polymerase beta, RNA primers and gaps are filled by DNA polymerase epsilon. Hence it is also called damage repair enzyme. These are all the different types of DNA polymerases present in the eukaryotic cells. Whereas in prokaryotic cells, so three different types of DNA polymerases, like first, second and third. So these are all the extra information of the DNA polymerase enzymes involved in the DNA replication. So after finishing of DNA replication, after completion of DNA replication, one parental strand produces two daughter DNA molecules. In the each daughter DNA molecule, one is the parental strand and the other one is the newly synthesized strand. So DNA replication is semi-conservative method. But important one information from the NCERT text material: choose the correct diagram for the DNA replication. Method of question is choose the correct diagram for the DNA replication. Your first diagram is A diagram. B diagram is the B1. Next one is the So these are all the five different diagrams of DNA replication by semi-conservative method. But here, according to from replication form, the formation of new strand, that is continuous strand and discontinuous strand or leading strand, right diagram is the D option. Because a very important direction, orientation of direction, and also Okazaki fragment direction. So in the last diagram, parental DNA templates are 5'-3' and 3'-5'. And the newly synthesized strand, that is leading and lagging strand direction, is 5'-3'. So here the correct option for our question is the D option. Important number of times appear question. And next to the replication of DNA by semi-conservative method, how the DNA replicates always in semi-conservative method? That is one simple arising question. Means in the daughter DNA molecule, one is completely old DNA, another one is the completely newly synthesized DNA strand. Sir, how do you prove? In the daughter DNA molecule, one is the parental strand, another one is the newly synthesized strand. That is one simple experimental proof to show that semi-conservative nature of DNA replication. That is present our topic heading of experimental proof for semi-conservative nature of DNA replication. Semi-conservative nature of DNA replication. Very important. Expected question from board exams. For the famous question, experimental evidence, experimental proof for semi-conservative nature of DNA replication. Listen here, students. The experiment, semi-conservative method of DNA replication, was first showed by Matthew Michelson and Franklin Starr. You should remember, this experiment was first showed by Matthew Michelson and Franklin Starr. Very important. Never Franklin Wilkins in DNA, Watson and Crick model of DNA. The X-ray crystallographic picture also was first developed by Franklin and Wilkins. Confused scientist names. So here, the experimental proof of semi-conservative method of DNA replication was showed by Matthew Michelson and Franklin Starr in the E. coli bacteria, Escherichia coli bacteria, in 1958. That's why this experiment was popularly known as Michelson and Starr experiment. Important. Briefly explain the Michelson Starr experiment for DNA replication, always semi-conservative method. Expected question by this forum. So, semi-conservative method of DNA replication is also called Michelson and Starr experiment. They were worked on experiment on Escherichia coli bacteria, E. coli bacteria, in 1958. See, these two scientists, Michelson and Starr scientists, grieve, like the Michelson and Starr grieve the E. coli bacteria, Escherichia coli bacteria, nothing but culture the E. coli bacteria in the culture medium containing 15 ammonium chloride. Very important. Belzinger, Michelson and Stahl grew the E. coli bacteria, Escherichia coli bacteria, in the culture medium containing 15 ammonium chloride solution in several generations, not only single generation, in many generations. In many generations. Yeah, the 15 ammonium chloride solution, very important, is the source of heavy N15 nitrogen. This is the source of N15 nitrogen because Pilsner, it is not the isotope, it is not a radioactive element, it is just a nitrogen element. This nitrogen element, N15 heavy nitrogen element, is not directly available in the nature. You should remember this statement in clearly. N15 nitrogen is not a radioactive element or isotope. This is a nitrogen element and doesn't directly available in the nature. That's why they may use 15 ammonium chloride solution in the culture medium as a source of, as a supplement of N15 heavy nitrogen in several generations, in many generations. And the result was found that, Belzinger, the result was found that the newly synthesized DNA strand, newly formed DNA strand incorporated by heavy nitrogen N15 element. You should remember, after growing of E. coli bacteria in the culture medium containing 15 ammonium chloride solution, it is a source of N15 nitrogen element. It is not a radioactive element, just an inorganic element. So, this N15 nitrogen element incorporated, means label attached, incorporated into the newly synthesized DNA strand. And the newly synthesized DNA molecule separating from normal DNA. You should remember this statement in clearly. Say, the newly formed DNA detected from normal DNA through DNA density gradient by using centrifugation technique with the help of cesium chloride as the density gradient solution. Density gradient solution. Listen here. Michelson and Stahl grew the E. coli bacteria in the culture medium containing 15 ammonium chloride solution. So after many generations, the newly synthesized DNA strand incorporated by N15 nitrogen element, heavy N15 nitrogen element, and the other old strand will be free. So, for example, this is one DNA strand, parental strand, present in the E. coli bacteria before cultured in the nutrient medium, culture medium containing 15 ammonium chloride solution. So, after some period of time, this DNA molecule, parental DNA molecule, undergo replication to produce new strands, new daughter DNA molecules. See here, in each daughter DNA molecule, the newly formed DNA, newly synthesized DNA, attached by N15 nitrogen. N15 nitrogen. Why? Other old template strand will be free. You should remember this statement. Other old template strand will be free. A newly synthesized strand attached by N15 nitrogen element. And once again, these E. coli bacterial cells allowed to them grow in the same culture medium containing 15 ammonium chloride solution.
And each parental DNA once again produced two daughter DNA molecules. Very important. This is the conclusion point of this experiment. See, your old strand as it is without labeled by old strand as it is without labeled by nitrogen element. Why? The newly synthesized strand labeled by N15 isotope on daughter DNA molecule. And the second strand labeled by N15, that will be observed old strand. N15, old strand. And in the newly synthesized strand labeled by N15 isotope. N15 isotope, because culture medium containing 15 ammonium chloride solution. This is the two daughter DNA molecules of one parental DNA. These are the two daughter DNA molecules of this parental DNA. Say, in one parental strand, one is the old strand, another one is the newly synthesized N50 nitrogen strand. In the daughter DNA molecule, each strand produces two daughter DNA molecules. In one strand, old template strand as it is. And the newly synthesized strand labeled by N15 nitrogen element, heavy nitrogen element. That is one strand of daughter DNA molecule. In the parental DNA, another N15 DNA strand is there. Now, this parental DNA labeled by heavy nitrogen N15 as it is. And the newly synthesized strand labeled by N15 isotope from the culture medium. So, the second daughter DNA molecule is the heavy DNA, because both the strands so filled by labeled by N15 nitrogen element, heavy element. In the second parental DNA, one is old strand as it is directly received from the parental strand, and from the culture medium observe the labeling the N15 heavy nitrogen element to produce new strand. This is one old strand of one newly synthesized strand. In another old template strand, N15 template strand, parental strand as it is. You won't be confused. In our explanation, N15 heavy nitrogen as the parental strand. Yeah, the newly synthesized strand observe the nitrogen element from the culture medium. So, after many generation to generation, old strand template, old normal template strand is very least, decrease in order and least in order, and increase the number of heavy nitrogen labeled DNA molecules. That is our experiment procedure. See, Michelson and Starr grew the E. coli bacteria in the culture medium containing 15 ammonium chloride solution. Here, what is the use of 15 ammonium chloride solution is, this is the source of heavy nitrogen N15 element, because the nitrogen is not directly available as in the form of isotopes, radioactive substances. That's why we have to use the 15 as the ammonium chloride solution. And culture and allowed to them in several generations. After several generations, the result was found that newly synthesized strand labeled by, incorporated by heavy 15 nitrogen element. So, this heavy nitrogen element DNA molecule, see here, we listen here. The heavy nitrogen element DNA molecule separating from normal DNA, distinguish from normal DNA through density gradient technique.
by using centrifugation machines with the help of cesium chloride solution, CSCL, cesium chloride solution as the density gradient solution. This means, listen here, the scientist so took the sample, collected the sample and filled in centrifugation tubes. Centrifugation test tubes containing cesium chloride solution as the density gradient solution. So after spinning them, after centrifugation technique, rotation technique, listen here, the heavy DNA strand, heavy DNA molecule containing both the N15 nitrogen elements present at the bottom of the test tube. Now, this is N15 heavy DNA, important for diagrammatic question because its density is more. Bara jasi de, jasi bara edukosra culture medium alli cesium chloride solution alli bottom of test tube alli arrange aagutade, test tube bottom alli organization aagutade. And well, the normal DNA, without label by parental DNA, this is parental DNA, without label by N15 isotope, sir, N15 nitrogen element present at the top of the test tube, top of the centrifugation test tube. This is normal DNA. So, the density gradient DNA, heavy DNA, distinguish from, separating from normal DNA by using density gradient technique through centrifugation technique, centrifugation machines with the help of cesium chloride solution as the density gradient solution. So, in the centrifugation technique, heavy DNA present at the bottom of the test tube and the normal DNA without label by N50 nitrogen element present at the top of the test tube means so floated on the surface of a cesium chloride solution. That is the detection example, detection method for the separation of a density DNA from the normal DNA. So this E. coli medium, E. coli bacteria, Escherichia coli bacteria containing heavy DNA labeled by N15 nitrogen element, present here, transferred into the another culture medium, say this E. coli bacteria, Escherichia coli bacteria containing heavy DNA N15, here both stands out, labeled by, incorporated by N15 nitrogen element, transferred into the another culture medium containing 14 ammonium chloride. It is the source of light, never heavy, light to N40 nitrogen element. We listen here, in the first culture medium, E. coli DNA labeled by N15 nitrogen element, heavy element. Now, this nitrogen containing E. coli bacteria transferred into the another culture medium containing 14 ammonium chloride solution. It is a source of light nitrogen element, that is N14 nitrogen element, and allowed to them grow into several generations. In the second culture medium also, this E. coli bacteria allowed to grow in several generations, very important, in which each generation of E. coli bacteria finished in 20 minutes once. One parental E. coli cell completes its reproduction within 20 minutes. So, Michelson Stahl scientist transferred the E. coli bacteria containing N15 heavy nitrogen DNA into the another culture medium containing 14 ammonium chloride solution. It is the source of light nitrogen element, that is N14 nitrogen element, and allowed to them grow into several generations, in which each generation of E. coli bacteria completed within 20 minutes. And they were collected DNA samples at every generation. Listen here. They were collected DNA samples at every generation, and the detector observed DNA nitrogen through density gradient technique by using cesium chloride solution. Listen here. After several generations of E. coli bacteria in the second culture medium containing 14 ammonium chloride solution, frequently took the samples and detected the DNA density gradient of DNA for their observation. Very important. They were collected the DNA sample from the culture medium after 20 minutes of the first generation. You should remember this statement. That is the observation point of Michelson and Stahl experiment. See, the collected DNA sample from the culture medium after first generation nothing but transferred from N15 culture medium to the N14 culture medium. Listen here. After several generations, they were took the receiving the DNA samples from the culture medium and detected the density gradient of DNA by using cesium chloride solution through centrifugation technique. And if the collected DNA sample after first generation of 20 minutes, when they were transferred from N15 culture medium to the N14 culture medium. Listen here. N15 culture medium to the N14 culture medium, they were observed that presence of only hybrid DNA or intermediate DNA after 20 minutes of first generation. See, the collected DNA sample have only hybrid DNA or intermediate DNA. That means one strand labeled by N15 isotope, N15 nitrogen element, another strand labeled by N14 nitrogen element. That is one mixed DNA. That means hybrid DNA or intermediate DNA. That means, for example, this is parental DNA. Whenever E. coli bacteria transferred from first culture medium to the second culture medium, both DNA is labeled by N15 nitrogen elements. After first generation of 20 minutes, this parental DNA labeled by heavy nitrogen element N15 produced two daughter DNA molecules. Two daughter DNA molecules. Two daughter DNA molecules. In the each daughter DNA molecule, old template strand, old strand that is directly receiving from the parental DNA labeled by N15 nitrogen element. And the newly synthesized strand labeled by N14 light nitrogen element, because culture medium containing 14 ammonium chloride solution, that is the source of light N14 nitrogen element. So after first generation, in one DNA molecule, one daughter DNA molecule, one is the parental strand or old strand labeled by N15 nitrogen element. A newly synthesized strand labeled by N14 nitrogen element. Same as this, in the second old template strand, that is directly the same from the parental strand, parental DNA, N15 nitrogen element. A newly synthesized strand of light nitrogen element. So, one strand is the N15, another strand is the N14. This is hybrid DNA, one type of intermediate DNA, hybrid DNA. So, after first generation for 20 minutes, the collected DNA sample having only intermediate DNA or hybrid DNA. And after the second generation of 40 minutes, Belizean, the collected DNA, the collected DNA have, very important, 50% of hybrid DNA and 50% of light DNA. See, this is the DNA molecule. These are the DNA molecules after first generation for 20 minutes. And after second generation, after 40 minutes. Now these two parental DNA molecules produce. Four daughter DNA molecules. Among the four daughter DNA molecules, two daughter DNA molecules are the intermediate DNAs or hybrid DNAs, and two daughter DNA molecules are the light DNAs. They are only labeled by N14 nitrogen elements, N14 light of nitrogen elements. For example, see, this is one parental DNA for next generation after second generation. Now this old template strand labeled by N15 isotope. These two daughter DNA molecules are one N15, no? N15 DNA template. Next newly synthesized strand N14 So N15 parental DNA newly synthesized. Was that prepared for the synthesis? N14 label DNA ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಮೋನಿಯಂ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇದೆ 14 ಅಮೋನಿಯಂ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ N14 ಲೈಟ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೋ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಲಿ ಸಿಂಥಸೈಸ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ N14 ಆನ್ N14 ಸರಿ N15 ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟಲ್ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಇನ್ ಅನದರ್ ಡಾಟರ್ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಯರ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ Your old strand is the N14. A newly synthesized strand is also N14 because medium is the 14 ammonium chloride solution. Now this is the light DNA because both strands are labeled by light nitrogen element, light N14 nitrogen element. And in the second daughter DNA molecule, second parental DNA molecule, one is the completely old, that is N14 directly receiving from the parental DNA, and newly synthesized in the culture medium labeled by N14 nitrogen element, and in another daughter or parental DNA, one is the old N15 and newly synthesized N14. So at each and every generation, one parental DNA produces two daughter DNA molecules. One parental DNA produces two daughter DNA molecules. In each daughter DNA molecule, one is the completely old strand directly receiving from the parental DNA. Another one is the newly synthesized strand. That's why Michelson and Stahl proved that replication of DNA is always semi-conservative method. So, after second generation of the 40 minutes, very important, 50% of DNA is the light DNA and 50% of DNA is the hybrid DNA. You should remember this statement in clearly. After 40 minutes of the second generation, Michelson and Stahl observed that 50% of food DNA is the light DNA, 50% of DNA is the hybrid DNA or intermediate DNA. Because in intermediate DNA, one strand labeled by N15 nitrogen element and the other one is the N14 nitrogen element. And important for extra information, after third generation, after 80 minutes, very important, say this is the result of a second generation of the 40 minutes, because E. coli cell divides once at every 20 minutes. So, after the 40 minutes of second generation, 50% is the light DNA, 50% is the hybrid DNA. And after third generation of 80 minutes, the result of Michelson and Stahl experiment is 25% of DNA is the hybrid DNA, 75% of DNA is the light DNA. Well, listen here, 25% of DNA is the hybrid DNA and 75% of DNA is the light DNA. For example, after second generation, to produce four daughter DNA molecules. In the each daughter DNA molecule, one is the 15, N15 and N14, that is hybrid DNA. And next one is the N14 light DNA. And another one is the hybrid DNA. One is the N15 strand, another one is the N14 strand. This is the result of second generation after 40 minutes. Then result of third generation after 80 minutes. 25% of DNA is the hybrid DNA, very important, and 75% of DNA is the light DNA, because they are continuously allowed to them grow in the 14 ammonium chloride solution in several generations. So at every generation, newly synthesized strand labeled by N14 nitrogen element. So here the number of light DNA molecules increasing order and number of hybrid DNA molecules decreasing order after third generation, after 80 minutes. See, after third generation of 80 minutes, within here, the parental four DNA molecules, produce 8 DNA molecules. Each one becomes 2. Produce 8 DNA molecules. Say 4 into 2, 8 daughter DNA molecules. In the 8 daughter DNA molecules, well, listen here, this is one parental DNA produced, these two daughter DNA molecules. One strand, one DNA molecule. So,
in parental DNA. One is the N14 as it is. A newly synthesized strand N14. This is one parental strand, and this is one newly synthesized strand. And for next strand, N14 and N14. And next daughter DNA molecule, only labeled by N14. Here also N14. As it is for two daughter DNA molecules. And next two parental DNA molecule produce four daughter DNA molecules. Here also N14. And the last strand only hybrid DNA. N14 and N15. Andre, one parental strand, one DNA molecule, two strands are synthesis. Parental strand, angle, parental strand as it is, newly synthesized strand, mustagi synthesis are the strand, N14 label. So, this strand, old strand, this N14 parental DNA, this parental DNA strand, this newly synthesized strand. And for this DNA, parental DNA, this is parental DNA strand, old template strand, this is newly synthesized strand. Next, N14, parental DNA, this is newly synthesized DNA strand. So, as like that, out of 8 DNA molecules, listen here, 2 daughter DNA molecules are the hybrid DNAs, and 6 daughter DNA molecules are light DNA molecules. Light DNA molecules. Well, listen here, the statement in clearly. So, in the Michelson star experiment, after third generation, after 80 minutes, they were observed that 25% of DNA is the hybrid DNA, 75% of DNA is the light DNA, only labeled by light nitrogen element N14. So, according to them, at every generation, one parental DNA produced two daughter DNA molecules. In each daughter DNA molecule, one is the old strand and the other one is the new strand. Very important. Hence, this method of DNA replication is called semi-conservative method of DNA replication. Very important. This is the procedure for experimental proof of semi-conservative method of DNA replication or Michelson-Menstahl experiment. Very important. And according to centrifugation tubes, the diagrammatic representation is, this is centrifugation test tube. Now, in the first tube, culturing of E. coli bacteria within the 14 ammonium chloride solution has only heavy DNA. Now, this heavy DNA present at the bottom of centrifugation tube. Now, this is heavy DNA labeled by N15 nitrogen element. Because its density is more, just if all of it is, other person of centrifugation technique connect for the other, our density of our DNA, bottom only, arrangement of the. So, this is the heavy DNA and labeled by N15 nitrogen element. After transferring into the under culture medium containing 14 ammonium chloride, 50% of DNA is the hybrid DNA and 50% of DNA is the light DNA. Very important. Second, this is hybrid DNA
labeled by N15 and N14 nitrogen element present at the middle of the test tube, centrifugation tube. Hybrid DNA, intermediate DNA, never too weight, never too light, it is intermediate. That's why this, the location is middle of the culture tube, centrifugation tube. And light DNA present at the top of the test tube, light DNA. And in the last centrifugation tube, well, listen here, this is the diagram of heavy DNA labeled by N15 nitrogen element, and this is the hybrid DNA present at the middle of the culture tube, centrifugation tube, labeled by N15 and N14 nitrogen element, and this is the light DNA only labeled by N14 and N14 nitrogen element. Very important, this is the diagrammatic representation of Michelson and Stahl experiment. So, according to them, each and every generation of E. coli bacteria, one parental DNA produced two daughter DNA molecules. In the each daughter DNA molecule, one is the old strand and the other one is the newly synthesized strand. Hence, the replication of DNA is always semi-conservative method. This is the experimental proof of semi-conservative method of DNA replication. On the next topic, that is the functions of the DNA, different functions of the DNA, and also one more important question for board exams, so differences between leading strand and lagging strand. I'll be continuing next class.